relativity is still a theory. So is Darwin's theory of evolution. And yet we have the audacity to say that global warming is accurate. It's more than a theory. How about how cold it's been this spring? I mean, personal data. Data shows that since 1998, its temperatures, average temperatures have been cooling. Do you have any idea what that cap and tax trade thing, bill that you passed, is going to do to the Sussex County poultry industry? That's how these houses, chicken houses, are heated, with propane. It outputs CO2. I mean, I'm putting CO2 right now as I speak. Trees need CO2 to make oxygen.
CO2
I mean, you can't top that. That's taxing
growth. You voted to tax an element in the carbon in the
industry. First of all, I understand. First of all, I disagree. I'm not going to put an argument in, but I disagree. And I believe that there are environmental issues. And you can cite warming or cooling or whatever, but I think ultimately there are environmental issues that have to be dealt with. I think long term, we do need to convert to the degree possible in this world to energy sources, which are not going to be the pollutants that we have today. We have to convert to energy sources which are not pollutants, as many of them are today. For example, front of that bill has any.
But that's a scientific equation to what energy is.
I'd like you to say, let me see. One of the things in that bill deals with clean, and I don't necessarily believe in clean coal per se, but I think coal could be a lot cleaner than it is. I believe we should be doing more with natural gas, and I think we should be doing a lot more with nuclear energy. I think these are all very important steps. None of these are
going to
end in this legislation, which is important. I believe that there is a problem.
They're not in that legislation, are they?
They are either in it or there's no prohibition about them in that legislation. Clean coal is in the legislation.
How does shutting down industries here in the United States and then shipping them over to China where they don't have the EPA regulations, how does that help the environment?
Well, first of all, there are many, many industries, and I got to run here, folks, but there are many, many industries which have indicated that not only will they not shut down, but they actually help them expand in terms of what they're doing. Starting with the pond company, among others. But many, many who got in touch with us, many different business groups who got in touch with us, and said that this is not going to affect their employment in one way or another. And there are those who believe in the various green energy things, be it the wind energy or the solar energy or the...
I guess time will tell.
Printed circuit board industry used to have 3,000 locations in this country. And as the tighter restrictions on pollutants, etc., drove a lot of them out of business and other reasons. But they don't pollute. They don't have to worry about pollution in China. My job was in the circuit board industry. It went to China. There's a handful of people making circuit boards in this country
now.
Well,
I think we have responsibility, by the way. You raise a very good point.
And I believe I don't want to pollute. I don't want to pollute.
But I believe when we go to China or in India and we go to Copenhagen in December or whatever and sit down and negotiate this, we've got to make demands on those countries. Not dissimilar from anything that's happening in America. And by the way, this bill may get changed.
Well, good luck with that.
Well,
good luck with that.
Part of what those things are for.
Because their air comes over here, too.
Right. Yeah.
Mayor, yesterday there was a call to the
Alliance.
Oh,
sure. And by the way,
they said today that LA
lost. I think it's nothing more than a wasteful tax. It's going to hurt industry and, what, cost the American people at least $2,500 a year. In hidden taxes by what they're going to have to pay for.
Why did you vote? I voted for it because I believe in the science.
You believe in the science of global warming? Because you believe in the science of global warming?
Yes, I do. I disagree, but I'm not going to argue. But I disagree.
Okay.
B, I believe that it had a number of other changes in terms of the fuels that we use that could be helpful as far as the future is concerned, which I think is important. Third, I believe there is an industry there in all this that Delaware can be taking advantage of, or should be taking advantage of, which I think is important. Fourth, I think that costs are overstated. I've read costs ranging from $3 a month on electric bills to $150 a year, which is probably the most expensive.
CBO, I've got a CBO report here, and it's anywhere. It also has a wealth distribution clause in it, which says rich households are going to pay more while poor households will receive a check. Isn't that wealth distribution?
its ability to pay. There is provision to help lower income and
so
middle income.
From,
tax everybody a lot, but then take more from the upper end and give it to the lower end.
So taxation's always worked.
From he who achieves to he who needs.
Well, I mean, I can't tell you why people have more to achieve. I mean, do you think some of the bankers,
from he who achieves to he who needs it?
He who achieves economically,
take it from them and give it to people who need.
Well, do you
that, do you agree with that statement?
What do you think about the taxes? We have the present taxes.
The present taxes? I am a fair tax. And I know that
you have some special use.
I'm sorry?
I agree with you on that.
No, you don't, because I looked on the website and you do not. And if that is the case, if you say you agree with it, these people have heard you say, I'm going to send you a copy of my decision. Hopefully you pay. You won't have to pay for it.
I want to see your description of a fair tax. The
fair tax.
There isn't the fair tax.
No, there is one version of the fair tax. I'm a volunteer for the Americans for Fair Taxation. The fair tax. And it'll put me out of business the second time. And that's okay, because I believe in America, and I believe that the fair tax is the only way to go for this country. So I would like to tell you, I will send it to you. The person who said that, to take from the wealthy to give to the poor, from people who achieve to give to the poor, was Karl Marx. And that was in part of the Communist Manifesto.
I know you call yourself a Republican, but would you also consider yourself a progressive?
Like, you,
no, I'm not a Republican. I'm not conservative.
They just vote for a while.
But, you know, there's a variety of ways.
No, I know. That was the one that you didn't vote for.
Right. And a lot of other spending bills, by the way.
All right.
Follow the record.
What is the...
We want to...